Hey everybody, in today's review we are taking a look at 11 Table Tennis VR for the Quest. It's funny how when you think of ping pong, you don't really think of something that's that exciting. Ping pong is one of the best things that you could convert into VR. And 11 Table Tennis VR is a shining example of that. More so than its competitors, 11 focuses on the true-to-life physics of table tennis, with the developer constantly fine-tuning the physics engine to make it feel as realistic as possible. I can personally vouch for this because I started playing this as a complete table tennis noob. I didn't even know how to properly serve the ball, let alone return it to the opponent without it flying off the table. However, in between moving houses, I was able to spend a good week getting used to the controls and getting used to how the ball would react given certain levels of force, the angle, and the placement of my paddle. So while it took some time, I felt myself physically get better and physically understand the physics more because the physics have a logical realism to them. I had to think and watch and discover why my actions in game were translating to the ball hitting the back wall and not the table itself. Or even bigger yet, how to serve the ball in a way that allows it to just barely jump over the net while retaining high amounts of speed. And it took a lot of lost matches, but I did it, and now I'm at a place where I'm starting to learn how to chop the ball on a serve to add spin to it. It's all very exciting, and the sense of accomplishment that I'm getting from learning how to do these things in VR that would very likely translate to the actual thing is just fantastic. And 11 does a really good job of giving you the tools, game modes, and various online opponents to effectively make that a reality. When you first boot up the game, you'll be paired off against an AI opponent that takes the form of your Oculus avatar, and you can free hit against him or her with the intention to keep the ball in play at all times, no matter what. There are no rules, there is no structure to the actual activity, it's a halfway decent way to just mess around and practice at the same time. Once you want to start getting serious, you have the option of playing against the AI in a semi-formal match format, where you have to correctly serve and make sure that your ball bounces on your table once before bouncing on the opponent's table once before they can react. The bots themselves are a pretty formidable opponent. Ranging from easy all the way to legendary, they will give you the just correct amount of difficulty to go up against once you find out just how good you are yourself. This is my preferred way to warm up in a game like this. When playing against the bot, sometimes it feels like you're just playing against another person, that's how good it feels. But the multiplayer against other online opponents is really where this game shines. You can pick from a list of opponents where it shows their ping, as well as their ranked score, which gives you an idea how many wins and losses they have when it comes to total ranked matches played. And while you will occasionally find some matches where the opponent's ping is in the several hundreds, the way they do it is pretty ingenious. The lag itself only affects your match in such a way so that you and your opponent can still reliably play hit after hit, because the only time you're going to see and feel that lag is when the opponent reacts to your hit and then tries to hit the ball. And there will be a slight delay. The ball will just kind of disappear for a second. It'll show their hit, and then half a second later, the ball will come flying towards you, and you have to be ready for it, but it's doable. And even though I'd say at least 25% of my opponents had terrible connections, it's still more than playable, consistently. Now, the best way to train against such opponents is to utilize the free and accessible training tools that this game allows you. There is a robot that shoots ping pong balls at you repeatedly, following the same pattern every time, but it's a good way to get that muscle memory going. Past that, you have this beer cup challenge, where you have to hit the ball in such a way that it will land in one of the cups, and then you have to get rid of all of the cups this way. The last training exercise has to do with the placement of your own hits, so there will be sections labeled on the board with various degrees of accuracy. Think a bullseye, it kind of looks like that, but it's on the opponent's side of the table, and you have to hit your ball and serve the ball in such a way that it will land in those particular spots. Now, the closer you are to the bullseye, the more points you get, and then the more points you get in the time limit raises your overall score and puts you on the leaderboard in a higher place. Kind of a fun way to learn and accomplish a high score at the same time. All of this is in preparation for the meat and potatoes of this game, of this Table Tennis Virtual Reality 11. Competitive ranked mode against other players, of course. Now, there really isn't any matchmaking so far. The way it works is you have a essential lobby system, and you can see who's online, you can see what their rank is, and you can see their ping. And you can send challenges to other players, and then you both select ranked or unranked. which is kind of cool if you just want to do casual practice. But yeah, you both select ranked, and then depending on your ranking score and their ranking score, whoever wins or loses will gain and lose the appropriate amount of ranking. And while there have been some times where I have been challenged by somebody who was way more experienced for me to the point where it just wasn't fun at all, there have been as many, if not more times, that I was challenged by somebody around my skill level, and we played for over an hour, if not hours at a time, ended up adding each other as friends to meet up again another day. And let me tell you, when that happens and you're both trying your best and you're both trying to learn at the same time and you're both on your microphones talking to each other, making jokes, doing, you know, funny poses when you win or lose, it is one of the best VR experiences that I have had to date. Between the socializing aspect of it and the way that you learn and compete at the same time, all of that melded together, it creates an experience that is worthy of a 9 out of 10 score. And I didn't even mention the visuals. They're pretty dang realistic, except for maybe the avatars themselves. Those are a little, plain. Yeah, they could be more, you know, maybe some inverse kinetics so that you can see a body and you can see arms would be kind of cool, but it's good enough for what it is. But the environments that you play in for the quest are pretty top notch. Your paddles, the ball, the headset, they all cast shadows at all times, no matter the distance from your position, which is really cool to see. You'll see the ping pong ball blast past you, you know, onto the bed or the couch, and it'll be casting a shadow always. And it's like, okay, you know, I'm kind of definitely in this space. It really sells the idea. It's very immersive, and the environments are very high quality. But even with those sharp, realistic visuals, this game is still an easy 9 out of 10. And the only reason I'm not giving it a perfect 10 out of 10 is just simply due to the fact that it's lacking that matchmaking that would make a lot of the headache behind finding another person to play with around your skill level a lot less of a headache. Because it can be annoying finding somebody who's either incredibly new to the game and you're just steamrolling, or someone who's so far above you that you think that they've been playing table tennis for years. Because good players, they can smurf. They can continually lose matches and eventually get to the point where their ranking is so much lower than their actual skill level that, well, you'll think, hey, this guy only has 50 points or so for ranking. And then you find yourself getting curb stomped with the back of his paddle. But past all that jazz, it's a phenomenal experience, and you should definitely put it on your playlist. Make it one of the first three games that you play on the Oculus Quest. And with that said, I'd like to know what you think of this review and the game 11 in the comments down below. If you enjoyed the video, hit that like button, subscribe for more reviews like this, hit that notification bell so you always know when I've uploaded new content, and I will catch you next time.